YSOO.
Hello, this is YSOO, and we are at the Danger Incorporated show at Trans Pecos. This is YSOO, and we are here with Danger Incorporated. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Louie.
I'm Booth.
So you guys are from Atlanta, right? Originally.
It's
so
true.
So what brought y'all to New York City to perform tonight?
Is the DMs or something? Maybe
the stars just aligned.
The stars
Someone
aligned.
Just said, hey, do you want to perform? And we were in that mood.
I hear there's an eclipse happening soon, so like
danger eclipse is what happened.
Nice. The danger eclipse. Okay, so obviously there's two of you in the group, and every duo has like a certain dynamic, I feel like.
Yeah.
So how do your personalities differ or complement each other?
I feel like I used to view us like, oh, we're the same person, but we're different people for sure.
Okay. Different people for sure.
Like the main difference, you'd say?
I guess musically, you know, I'm cranking on the beats.
Mm.
I think Boothor's setting the vibe.
Okay. Your latest single is called Flashlight. And it has a different sound from your previous music. It has like really heavy bass and like distorted vocals. So what inspired this new kind of sound?
I feel like in the grand scheme of like the music we're about to drop, it's probably the only one with distorted vocals like that.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's just how like we'll crank out demos and then like.
It's whole eras of danger that niggas have never seen and probably will never see, just because like niggas be like. Things be evolving quick. Mm. There's not a single tape that sound like another tape on God, and it will never be that way. So it's just like,
so
I don't know.
We always like to evolve and show a new different side with every...
Because we do. We do that. Because we do that.
Throwing it back to your first album, World Wide Web.
Throwing it back.
It explored the internet a lot and the culture of the internet. So would you say that you both grew up being chronically online?
I wouldn't say chronically,
but we was online.
We was online.
And as far as music came to us, a lot of it came from online.
Yeah. And y'all also have that song Love on the internet, so I wanted to ask, how has the internet shaped your like personal relationships?
Killed it. Killed my love.
Okay.
I don't know. I don't think my love relationship depends on the internet that heavily. I think it's
That's
more
good.
Of an organic, in the flesh fruition, I would say.
In your song Graveyard, also a throwback, you say, I'm at home watching Disney original movies.
Definitely.
So what's your favorite one?
My favorite Disney original movie. That's tough.
That's tough.
That's tough. But.
Damn.
It's like choosing your favorite kid, you know?
Yeah.
Bro.
What
was the one that we watched? That one on the couch at Guru House, and like we watched the whole movie. And like,
what was the plot?
Could not
of
recall
it?
A single piece of it.
Time Stoppers.
Time Stoppers.
I don't know if this
nigga.
Is a Disney original though.
I feel like, oh, is it not?
Do y'all remember Smart House?
It. Of course, that's up there.
That one was crazy.
That one's like top five.
Yeah.
Jump. The house is jumping.
I think my favorite is Phantom of the Megaplex.
I don't know that one.
That one's same era.
Okay.
I was like that.
I'll look it up.
The 13th year.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
but,
that's a
that one's probably my favorite.
Okay, nice. In the 2010s, you guys were part of a wave of artists that were making like very specific kind of music.
Oh.
And I would group y'all in with like, you know, I'm trying to think of like artists that were like, like during that time, maybe like Spooky Black, Young Lean, like all this music that was big on Tumblr and stuff. So I want to know, like, do you guys think this genre has transformed or like disappeared or
evolved? And that's like the whole thing. It's like,
I feel like it was definitely an era.
Yeah,
too.
It was
like
an
in
era.
The 2010s.
It was an era, and it's like, but an era is like shapes the future. So it's like, you know, both. But yeah, it's not there no more.
It's not there no more, yeah.
But like, not in a bad way. It's like, that's like, it's good.
All right, next question. So in the Birds Fly By Night album cover, you guys are releasing doves into the air. Is that a real, was that real?
That shit was dumb real. It was a old crinkly nigga with dumb crates of doves. and like we would like hold him. We'd be like, and then we would let him go, and he's like, they just gonna fly back to the house. Like it's good.
Back to their home base.
I was like, are you sure? Like
your music has a lot of spooky undertones. Have you guys always been spooky?
I don't know. I feel like musically, we've always been spooky.
Bro, not even just musically. I remember the day I met this nigga. It's always been spooky. It's always been, and like spooky is like almost an objective word. It's like shit just always been like, it's been lowest key unsettling vibes, but like campy, like fun, fun, but like not like, not necessarily accessible type beat, you know? It's like, I don't know. It's always been spooky, but like once we understood that, we ran with that shit for sure.
Yeah. Would y'all actually hang out in graveyards?
Literally, you think it's a joke? It's not.
You do.
We have.
That's swag. Okay, so since y'all are spooky, are you excited for Halloween? It's coming up soon.
Every day is Halloween.
Every day is Halloween. Every year we're looking towards exactly. October, but then it's October every
it's
day
October
of the year.
Every day. Mm-hmm. When you spooky, every day feel like Halloween.
So true. Do y'all dress up or no?
We dress up
every day.
I think I'm about to be.
So true.
Like,
yeah. What are you gonna be?
What is it? The dude from. Lord of the Rings, the duo. You got Legolas and then what's his name?
Legolas
and nice. The brown haired dude. That's
oh yeah, that's you. That's
so I'm dressing up.
You, bro.
That's me right now with this beard, bro. We're gearing up for that.
My Halloween costume is I want to be the prophet from Elden Ring when you like first hop in and it's like niggas got that like he's got a bell, a torch, and that big old like piece of wood on his neck. You know what I'm talking about?
So you gotta get a big old piece of wood.
With a neck hole.
Thank you so much, Danger Incorporated.
Love.
Thank you.
Peace from
Thank
Wires
you.
OO. Can y'all do an OO for me?